Welcome to Real Estate Mortgage Shop, where we offer solutions to your real estate and financing scenarios. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage professional. Catch this podcast and more at jogarner.com. Good morning, Memphis, and welcome to our internet listeners and podcast listeners across the 50 states. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop, and I'm your host, Joe Garner, Mortgage Loan Officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. Our general topic today is your home and your financing, the power of vision to forge a new life. Subscribe to get our weekly blog post and podcast at jogarner.com. You can call us while we're live today at 901-535-9732. Today is May 4th, 2019. Today we're talking about your vision for the way that you want to live. We're going to be sharing some stories of people who put to action the design they had in their minds for the way they wanted their home to look and feel and the comfort they wanted to feel with their financing arrangements. Sitting in the co-host chair today, we have our expert landscaping designer, John Lawhon of Lawhon Landscaping. John, I have heard many testimonies about the quality of your work. You help people get a vision of the way that they want the outside of their home or business to look and feel. You do big projects, little projects, and sometimes you do those really big projects in phases. Tell our new listeners a little bit about yourself and what you do for your clients. Well,
thank you, Joe. I grew up in the industry. My dad was a horticulturalist. He formed his own company in 1958 with my mom. And so I grew up doing this kind of thing and went to a college at LSU and got a degree in landscape architecture. In 1984, my brother and I and my wife formed a separate entity of landscaping. We're landscape contractors. We're licensed bonded. We've been doing this for many years, primarily on word of mouth. But so we understand the concept of quality. And we try to help people with their vision of what they want to do with their yard.
Mm-hmm. And that really does affect the way we live and enjoy our homes.
Absolutely.
and our businesses. Well, you know, John, just like you help people get a vision for how they want the outside of their home to look and to work, I help people design their financing to help make their vision a reality. And, you know, getting a vision in mind of what you yearn for in life and what you want your life to look like reminds me of something my sales coach told me a while back. He said, when you have a clear vision, you will have greater endurance. Then he told me the story of Diana Nyad, the first person known to swim from Cuba to Florida unaided. Diana tried several times to accomplish this goal and failed. Once she was attacked by a jellyfish. Another time she tangled with some very aggressive sharks. I mean, the lady, I mean, she lived quite on the edge there. But most of her failures came from just sheer fatigue. The final time she made the attempt to swim from Cuba to Florida, she was becoming extremely tired, just like times in the past. But this time her coach, who was on a nearby boat, looked up and started yelling to Diana, "Look up at the light. Do you see that light ahead?" Diana was so worn out as she swam, she could just barely see a light in the distance, and she thought it was a sunrise or something. But her coach started waving his arms and jumping up and down and yelling even louder, "That light is the Florida coastline. Don't give up, Diana. Keep swimming." Once Diana got the clear vision of the Florida coastline, a new flood of adrenaline pushed her forward with a new endurance that bolstered her across to accomplish her vision and her goal and broke the record, of course. By the way, just for some of y'all out there, Diana Nyad was in her 60s when she made that record breaking swim.
That's amazing.
just a little side note there. But what do you want to be as a human? What does your home and your home life look like the way you want it to be? How do you want your family situation to be? Do you want children? Do you want to entertain a lot and have friends in your home, family? How do you want to feel on a typical day in your life, at home, at work? What do you want people to be saying about you? those are some of the questions that, you know, you could ask yourself to start formulating that vision of how you want to be, how you want life to be. I challenge you to build a vision board for yourself. My retired U.S. Navy friend, they used to do this in the Navy, do vision boards, and she convinced me to make one, and they really work. I wasn't sure at first how that would happen, but I did that a few years ago. It was amazing. Print some pictures that represent the way you want your life to look and feel, pictures that represent those things, your home, your work, more. But cut pictures out of magazines, print pictures off of the internet and that you find online, paste them on your vision board, and then put your vision board somewhere where you can see it every day and then just watch what happens. I've been in the mortgage business for almost 30 years, and I've seen so many ways real estate has fortified a good life for my customers. I believe you can accomplish anything owning real estate. And if you buy it right and you keep buying more of it, the possibilities are endless on what you can do in life for yourself and for those around you. Make your plan. Let's work your plan. If the deal works for you today, let's do it today. Connect with me at jogarner.com. You can call me the old-fashioned way. I love to talk and listen to your stories. 901-482-0354. Let's talk about what you want to accomplish with your mortgage. But, John, we're going to come back to some of these superstar, I call them my superstar clients who have just done incredible things using real estate and financing. But right now, let's take a moment and let's start talking about the power of creating a vision of what you want to do with your home or your business and how to put that into action with a landscape design.
Right. Talking about the vision is exactly what we do. We first do an analysis to determine what the client's needs are, what the space is primarily used for, and then we interview the customer to see what it is that they want, what their lifestyle is. Do they have children? Do they have pets? I've had a customer that recently wanted a cutting garden. All these things had to be taken into account. Is it possible? Is terrain a problem? Or I had another client just recently, and what they wanted to do, I tried to explain to them that it's very expensive. We found a cheaper alternative that still made good use of their property.
What they want to do?
What they wanted to create, one of them wanted a more useful playground area for their children.
Mm-hmm.
There was a big drainage issue down there, and we looked at some other alternatives, mm-hmm, of how to do this on an economical way and went within a budget framework.
Mm-hmm.
All these things are important. Doesn't matter how fancy the plan is, if you can't afford it, it won't work.
If you can find ways to make that lifestyle the way they want it on their budget.
Right. And a lot of times we do things in phases. I've had one customer we've done work for 5 years doing each part of the plan each year.
Well, you know, and I was listening to a podcast. I'm a podcast junkie. I was listening to a podcast this week about landscaping and how, you know, when you're trying to look for a house to buy or you're going to live there, you're just going to stay there in your house, then if you have a lot of kids or teenagers even that are going to roll around in the grass, play in the lawn, it's good to have one of those cushy lawns, you know, where you seed it, you feed it, you nurture it so that it's one of those carpet-like lawns, so it's fun and memorable to roll around in that grass.
Right. You won't get hurt either.
Right, so you don't get hurt. And, you know, they were talking about how people who love to have fresh flowers and arrange flowers in their home, it's good to have a flower garden right outside the patio, right outside the door, where they can easily just take a few steps, cut their flowers, and bring them in the house. Cooks, it's great to have an outdoor space that's close to the kitchen so they can cook inside, outside, and entertain. Just all those things that you want to keep in mind when you are planning that living space.
And with the cutting garden we're doing right now, we had to plan it out so that you have a long period of time which you can grow your flowers. Different things come in at different times of the year.
Oh, that's a great idea. Well, you know what? You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. What do you want to accomplish with your mortgage? Make your plan. Let's work your plan. If the deal works for you today, let's do it today. When we come back, John Lawhon's going to be sharing some more smart ideas on how to design your landscaping for the way that you want to live. See you guys back in just a moment.
600 WREC and 92.1 FM.
Hello, I'm Gina Davis with FindVendorBooth.com. You're listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Now back to your host, Joe Garner.
Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm all right song. My power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes. Cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me.
All right, you're back on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I am Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You can also call me up the old-fashioned way, 901-482-0354. Sitting in the co-host here today, we have John Lawhon of Lawhon Landscaping. You guys have been around since, is it 1958?
Yes, almost older than dirt.
Almost older than dirt.
That's what I feel like sometimes.
Well, we're glad to have you in the co-host chair. And John, today we're talking about your home and your financing, the power of vision to forge a new life. And we're going to be getting into some ways that you can do that with your landscape design, making the way you live, the way, and maybe even at your office, the way you want things to be. But we're also going to be talking about some superstar clients of mine later in the show and how they forged an entirely new and better life just using some tools with financing. But right now we're going to take a moment and we're going to play a game that we like to play almost every Saturday, and it's called the Look Back Memphis Trivia Contest. The Look Back Memphis Trivia Contest is sponsored by, well, you, John. John and Jennifer Lawhon of Lawhon Landscape, 901-754-7474. The Lawhons can help you plan your landscaping if you have a really big, big project, or maybe a smaller project, or maybe you want to do that really big project in phases. The Lawhons are giving away a $25 gift card to the first person with the correct trivia answer. And if you know the answer to our trivia question, give us a call at 901-535-9732. 901-535-9732. John, what is our trivia question? And give us some hints on it.
The question is, who am I? Hint, I am the very center of a town that is a suburb of Memphis. Next hint, the town's first location was east of where it is located now. The first location of this town was destroyed in the bloodiest Civil War battles in Shelby County, Tennessee. But the new town was incorporated February 17, 1870 at its current location. The center of this town is listed on the National Register of Historic Places. And the last hint is, this location served as the site for various organized events such as the Cheese Carnival, Watermelon Festival, There on the Square, Mulberry Fine Arts Festival, Dickens on the Square, and many others.
I've got one more hint. John Lawhon designed the center of this town that we're talking
about. The landscape.
The landscape. You designed the landscaping for it, and so that's our last hint. I just wanted to add that, John. All right, so while we're waiting on our answer, 901-535-9732, if you know the answer, we're going to go back to John Lawhon. You know, we're talking about your home and your financing, the power of vision to forge a new life. John, earlier in the show, you were talking about very strategic questions to ask yourself to determine how you want to live in your outdoor space and what types of landscaping you would do there, depending on who's going to use the space, how you're going to use it, when you're going to use it. And you were already giving some ideas on how to do that. But let's continue on now, and let's talk about, you mentioned drainage, and right now we've had a lot of rain in the Mid-South,
right.
And so talk about how to deal with some of those irrigation issues.
Right. Well, I tell my clients right now, we've had tremendous amount of problems with drainage this year, as you might well have already experienced yourself.
Yes.
A little problem becomes a major problem under these conditions, but I always tell my clients, first of all, don't get overly concerned. You need to be concerned, but this is not normal. But any kind of small problem becomes a major problem when we have periods where you're over 10 inches of rain above normal. So we just have to – you have to look at the situation, how it can be solved. You don't want to increase the amount of water on your neighbors. So doing a proper analysis of this is always important to start with.
Mm-hmm.
And then trying to find out the best way to handle it that really will work. We have a lot – we could go back and redo a lot of projects where people have done them incorrectly, or they've had a contractor that did not – really do it right on the, to start with. So these things are real important as far as drainage goes.
Well, I know before the show, you and I, because I used to be in the landscaping business many years ago. I had a lawn and landscape service, and up in Jackson, Tennessee, we were all women except for two of our part-time guys, which they were they had it really good, let me tell you. But what a fun time. It was a lot of hard work, and I can certainly appreciate what you do, John, and the expertise that you bring to the table. And you and I were talking before this radio show today, and you were talking about how much money people lose if they don't take care of their landscaping that they have. And it's very important that they get somebody like you who knows what's going to work and what's not going to work. Because what looks, a lot of people think, oh, it's pretty, and they plant it there, but In the long run, it's going to cost them a lot of money. Talk a little bit about that.
Oh, yeah. I've just had a consultation with a customer that their plants have grown so out of control that a lot of them are going to have to be removed, and because it can't be reclaimed. Some things are very forgiving, and you can cut them back really far, but you've got to know what the, what it is. Don't just go out there hacking on things. They may not recover. I've even seen some commercial projects where the people came out there and cut, say, junipers all the way back beyond the foliage, and they all died. It's just having a little knowledge goes a long way, and trying to be proactive and not let it get to that situation. We had one last year, the hollies in the front. They were the wrong things to start with. They were hedge hollies, and they were used as a foundation plant. Well, they were 17 feet tall. There was no way to save any of that. You couldn't even see the house.
Mm-hmm.
So all of that, every bit of that had to come out of there and had to be redone. Other times, there, like I said, there are opportunities to reclaim things and repurpose some of the plants. So it just takes some kind of knowledge, and we're happy to do a consultation.
I want to come back to that repurposing, because that can save you thousands of dollars, and I know you do that so well. But we have a trivia winner. We've got Pamela on the line. Pamela, what's the answer to our trivia contest today?
Collierville Town Center.
All right.
So right.
What was the hint that gave it away?
Well, it helped that you said east of Memphis.
And, that could be Germantown or Rossville, so.
Well, it could be. I've lived in both, and so I decided the town center, and that you had, that John had landscaped it. They have a beautiful landscape town center.
Well, you know, John designed that.
Yes, I know. And it helped me to know the answer to that.
Well, Pam, have you spent a lot of time there yourself?
I have.
I know. I love eating there, just hanging out there. It kind of takes you back.
Fair on the Square this weekend. So.
Oh, yeah, they've got Fair on the Square this weekend.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Pam, we appreciate you calling and listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Be sure and leave your name, your address, and your phone number with our producer so that the Lahans can send you a $25 gift card.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pam. We appreciate you so much.
Okay.
Congratulations to Pam. I tell you, she nailed that one, didn't she?
Yeah, that was great.
Well, you know, we've got just a few minutes here. Let's continue. I want to talk about something that you have done for people who are trying to sell their house and they were on a budget. And I'm thinking about one customer in particular, who said, you know, my landscaping has gone to pot. I know there's something I need to do with it. I want to get the most from my house. I need to sell it quick, but I've got to have some curb appeal. But I'm on a budget. So you were able to go out there for customers like them and say, here's what we can do. We can trim up this over here. We can take this existing plant that you have in the wrong place, and we can move it over to the right place. You don't have to buy a new plant. You can just move it over here, and we'll move it over there for you.
Right.
Talk about situations like that.
I've got a client. In fact, we do a fair amount of this. I've got a client right now, and they're actually friends, and they have that same dilemma. Their plants were so overgrown. A lot of them had died. Now they're trying to sell their house, and they want to move out to Rossville where they can downsize.
Mm-hmm.
And we're trying to figure out how to repurpose these plants, what we can do to give the best bang for the buck, to give CLRB appeal without them having to spend so much money on something they're going to leave.
Right.
So that's what we're working on right now. I mean, and we're doing exactly what you talked about. We're taking some of their plants, we're rearranging for mm-hmm. better impact, and then we're adding some things in there that's going to give a little oomph to it, a little color,
mm-hmm.
a little interest, something that makes it look like it's a well-manicured. And if you don't, I had a customer, actually another friend, he took everything out of his house, everything.
Mm-hmm.
And he told me, he said, well, I thought they just wanted to maybe do it themselves. Where no, it took him like a month. And finally he called me and I said, well, let me come up with something. And had some stuff in the nursery that was a little bit, you know, overgrown. But I said, you can have these and you can buy these cheap. And he sold his house within 2 weeks.
Right.
After he actually did it. He did it himself. But that's the point. You can't sell something that's not up to standard of the neighborhood.
Well, you know, going back to that, I learn a lot from realtors and my clients. I get an education every day from them. I love to have coffee with realtors and people who are boots on the ground out there in the field. Over and over again, I have heard people talk about how they could not get a client to go look at a house that may be beautiful on the inside, mm-hmm. but looked terrible on the outside. The landscape had not been kept up. It looked bad. Things were planted in the wrong place. And buyers would drive by it and say, nah, I don't want to look at it. I didn't like the outside of it. So you know what? You can't get them in the house till you can win them on the curb appeal on the outside. So there are some things that you can do if you are trying to sell your home on a budget. Give John Lawhon a call. He'll go shopping out in your backyard, and he may be able to find some things you already have and just trim them up or move them over to where they're going to look better and really make your yard pop. John, how can we reach you?
You can call us at 754-7474. And better yet, Joe, so let's try to do something before you sell it so you don't have to do all that work for somebody else.
There you go.
You can at least enjoy it a little while.
You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I am Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You can also find me at 901-482-0354. When we come back, I'm going to be sharing some stories from my superstar clients I've had who have used financing as a tool to take them from where they are, leaps and bounds, to where they wanted to be. We're talking about the power of vision to forge a new life. We will see you guys back in just a moment.
Hi, I'm Eric Urich, Focal Point Business Coaching, getting you to where you need to be. You're listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Now back to our host, Joe Garner.
All right, that's Pink, A Million Dreams. I love that song. It just reminds me of what we're talking about today. We're talking about your home and your financing, the power of vision to forge a new life. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You know what? You can subscribe there at jogarner.com, and we'll send you every week in your inbox our Real Estate Mortgage Shop podcast, and we'll even include the show notes for you. We won't sell your email. We want to stay friends, and would love to stay connected with you. And just give me a call. I would like to hear your story of where you are, where you want to go. as far as your financing, it would just be a joy to be on the journey with you. Even if you're not ready to step out there just yet, you just want to kind of see what may be available, give me a call. In the co-host chair, we have John Lawhon of Lawhon Landscape. And you've been doing some landscaping around here lately since it's stopped raining for a few days. How do we contact you, John?
Call us at 901-754-7474.
You know, since we're talking about the power of vision to forge a new life, I've got some superstar clients that I'd like to share their story. I just love talking about them, and I have a whole bunch of them, too. I have a whole bunch of clients who are superstars. I consider them superstars. Let me tell you a story about Martina. Martina, she became a savvy real estate investor on a buy, fix it up, and cash out refinance model, where she would go out and buy a house that needed a lot of work. She'd pay cash for it. And I'm going to tell you how she did that. And then she would come back to me, and I would just do a quick cash back refinance for her and get her a lot of her money back so she could pay her credit lines off and go do it over and over again. Sometimes she would resell those houses for a nice profit. Sometimes she would just keep them and rent them for a nice profit. So, but let me tell you how Martina started out. Martina was working a 9-to-5 job, but every day her heart was just yearning to bike across Europe with her friends and sail into adventures around the world. And it was just so frustrating and disappointing and discouraging for Martina. Even though she did a good job, she was a good worker, but every day she caught herself daydreaming about what she really wanted her life to look like. She felt like Cinderella stuck in the drudgery of work she didn't like, with no prince and no fairy godmother anywhere in sight, no financial way out. But, you know, some of Martina's friends had started small, you know, just making some money, buying and selling real estate, and they started encouraging Martina to buy her first rental property. Martina thought, if I could buy enough income-producing real estate properties, after a while, I could afford to jump into some of these adventures I've been daydreaming about. But pushing down fear and calling up some chutzpah, Martina went in with one of her real estate investor friends and they went in together on a deal and made a nice profit buying and upgrading a home and reselling it. And she had a nice little nest egg there from that profit. Then Martina started searching after work to go find homes and stable areas that needed quite a bit of renovation and repair. Martina sold her motorcycle and borrowed against her 401k to do her own deal. She used some of that profit also from the course of the last real estate deal, and she paid cash for a house. She got the house at a really discounted price because it needed a lot of repairs. She paid cash for it, and the reason is because a lot of your mortgage companies won't do a loan on a house that has a lot of major repairs until after the repairs are done. So she paid cash and made the repairs to the home, and started renting it at a nice profit, and then came to me, and I refinanced it. Once the house was completed, I gave her what I call the quick cashback refinance program. That's my name for it. Martina refinanced, paid back her 401k, pocketed some of the other profits, and then she told me, she said, let's go do the next deal. Martina had a formula for success that she could use over and over again. And before long, the life of adventure that she had yearned to live, it was going to be a reality, but it would happen little by little.
Well, you know what you were exactly what we were saying. She had to have a vision, and you had to help her with that vision.
Yes, and it was a joy to be on the journey with her too, John. But investors like Martina use the same quick cashback refinance program to pay back their credit lines, just like she did. And they pay cash for real estate. They use those credit lines to pay cash for the real estate. And then I refinance, pay the cash, the credit lines back, and they go do it over and over again, just like a launching pad. And after you do that a few times, you start making some real money.
Well, I know I can give a personal testimony about your success with helping us and a lot of my employees actually being able to finance their house. And you helped us as well. So it's just amazing, Joe, what you do. It really is. This is not pandering. This is the truth.
Thank you.
I'm not a good liar, so.
Thank you very much. Well, and I enjoy it. But Let me tell you another story about Mr. Ratcliffe. Now, he needed to restructure some debt and get it, and he wanted to get his mortgage paid off early in order to live out his vision. And Mr. Ratcliffe, of course, not his real name, made a resolution to pay off debt that had a stranglehold on him. He said, "I had some unexpected life events that cost me lots of money. One after another, they just kept hitting me. I could never catch a break. Before I knew it, several years had gone by, and I was drowning in debt." There is a wise saying that until you are so miserable in your current situation that the risk of stepping out to make changes is less daunting than staying where you are. So you'll never take that chance and make that change until you are miserable enough in your other situation to make jump out there and do it. Mr. Ratcliffe experienced the face-slapping realization that his life was being sucked out of him by piling up debt. He forced himself to tally up what he owed to each creditor and how much interest he was paying for each account. He was paying double-digit interest rates on these accounts. He called and managed to get some of the interest reduced just by simply asking. He owed about $100,000 on his mortgage with about 18 years left on it. His house was valued around $250,000. He refinanced back to a 30-year mortgage, pulled the cash out enough to pay off over half of those double-digit interest rate credit cards. Yes, he was back to a 30-year loan on his mortgage. But by putting most of the double-digit interest rate credit cards on a 5%, at that time, this happened a while back, on a 5% fixed rate mortgage, he freed up several hundred dollars a month. His next plan of action was to first apply the several hundred dollars a month savings to systematically pay off the rest of the credit cards over time. And then second, we had all this on a plan. Once the credit cards are all, the rest of the credit cards are paid off, he could take several hundred dollars of the savings each month and start automatic prepayment plan to go toward getting rid of his mortgage. The way we had it set up, John, he was going to get rid of his mortgage in less than 15 years when this plan, it was like a three-step plan, you know, he would not have a mortgage at all in less than 15 years. Mr.
That's
Ratcliffe
wonderful.
Made a commitment and to his goal. He did it. He was doing it. I've got one more story. I've got a couple of minutes. Man, I've got so many stories. I wish I could talk to you guys about some of my clients. They rock. But anyway, let me tell you one more story. I'm going to tell you Ricky's story. Ricky was a first-time home buyer. He could fix anything. If Ricky couldn't fix it, it wasn't broke, you know. But he wanted to shop, and he wanted to live in a certain neighborhood where he had grown up, but he couldn't afford it. He was newly, you know, getting started in his career, and he just couldn't afford it. So what he ended up doing, he ended up finding a house on the outskirts of that area. It wasn't quite as expensive a house. It did not have a shop, but it had a double garage. So what Ricky did is he bought that house, and he started little by little converting that double garage into a shop with a rack with his tools and all kinds of things. It was really cool. And then he began to make money over there, and he was having a lot of fun, but he did not want to remain there. So this was not a forever home for him. It was a starter home, but he had his shop because he made it work. His plan was to eventually, once he built up equity in the home and all of that and built up his income on his job, he was going to sell that home and buy in the neighborhood where he wanted, you know, leverage himself in there where it did have a shop. But as it turns out, Ricky was like, you know, I don't know if I want to sell this house. It's pretty good rent over here. I may want to rent this house out and just have more income to apply toward the house he was going to eventually buy in the new neighborhood. So there are so many things that you can do if you just can take a little while, ask yourself some questions, find out where you are and where you want to be. And then as you go along, you may change your vision, just like Ricky did, but it's all good. You're on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I am Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com, and I would love to talk with you, listen to your story. 901-482-0354. What do you want to accomplish with your mortgage? When we come back, John Lawhon of Lawhon Landscape is going to be sharing our real estate tip of the week. We'll see you guys back in just a moment.
600 WREC and 92.1 FM.
I'm Troy McDonald.
And I'm Lynn McDonald.
With the Aaron McDonald Insurance Agency.
From Memphis, Tennessee. And you're listening to the Real Estate Mortgage Shop. And now back to your host, Joe Garner.
All right, you're back on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage loan officer. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. You can send me an email, jo@jogarner.com, or just call me. Just tell me what your plan is. Let's talk about where you are and where you want to go. You can call me 901-482-0354. In the co-host chair, we have John Lawhon of Lawhon Landscape. John, you and your family, you make it a family affair, and you're passionate about what you do in landscaping and the things that you can help people do to change their life. You know, today we're talking about your home and your financing, the power of vision to forge a new life.
Joe, I just want to make a comment on that last segment. You are so very good at being able to help people find and make their vision become reality. I've seen this time and time again. It's just amazing, really.
Thank you, John. I appreciate that. It is one of the things that makes me excited about getting up in the morning and going to work.
It's your passion that makes a difference. You just don't do it. You live it.
Thank you, John. Well, we're going to take a moment and do something we do every week on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. The Real Estate Tip of the Week. And John Lawhon, I believe you have our Real Estate Tip of the Week.
Yes, I do. I've been a Boy Scout leader for many, many years and in the Boy Scout program. Our motto of the Boy Scouts is be prepared. And so as a volunteer and in life, you, as well as in landscape, that applies to everything. You need to prepare yourself on your landscape in advance so that you don't have so much to have to do and so much money you have to put in later in order to do a reclamation job. Start early doing the maintenance. Keep up with it. Don't let things get out of control.
Don't let the monkey grass take over.
Don't let everything take over. Poison ivy, I've seen that recently too.
I know. There's so many stories I know you could still tell today, but we're going to take a moment. We've got some Talk Shop announcements. Talk Shop offers free networking and education to anyone interested in real estate or in business. Talk Shop meets every Wednesday, 9 to 10 a.m. over at Pino's Palette, 8225 Dexter Road in Cordova, Tennessee. This Wednesday, May 8th, Jana Cordona of Business Network International is going to be talking about knowing your strengths. Knowing your strengths, how this can impact your success. So be there at Talk Shop, and it's free. We even make the coffee for you. Talk Shop events are free thanks to supporters like Nita Black of 901elearn.com. Nita Black can show you how to share your knowledge to teach others, and you can make money doing it. Thank you also to Adrian Keeley of Tiger Paws Carpet Cleaning, where your carpets and upholstery aren't clean until they are Tiger Paws clean, tigerpawscarpet.com. And pull up some of your Star Wars movies, charge up your old lightsaber, and may the Force be with you this Star Wars weekend. You can also head down to Memphis in May, Bill Street Music Fest. That's going to be pretty fun.
And fair on the square.
Thank you, John. Subscribe at jogarner.com. You'll get our weekly Real Estate Mortgage Shop blog post and podcast conveniently right there in your inbox. Real Estate Mortgage Shop wants to remind you to make your plan. Let's work your plan. If the deal works for you today, let's do it today. Got a couple of quotes, John. This one's from Rich Dad. The sky is never the limit. Your vision is.
The sky is
never the limit. Your vision is. Here's another one. This is from Anonymous. Create a vision that makes you want to jump out of bed in the morning. If you're wondering if you've got the right vision, if you're wondering if you're putting together a design that's going to work for you, ask yourself this question. Does this vision that I have for where I want to go make me want to jump out of bed in the morning?
Even if it's cold.
Thank you, John. Even if it's raining, I'm telling you. So This subject is just, I get on fire, you know, on this subject about vision boards and really making your life better. But John, is there anything else you wanted to add? I know we were covering some of your design stories and ideas. So anything else you want to share?
Well, if you need help with any of your problems out there, we consider ourselves problem solvers. So please give us a call and let's talk and see what we can do for you.
Yeah, I need you to get you out to my house and look at my trees.
We can do it.
And, you know, I wanted to talk really briefly since we've got just a few minutes before we're going to have to leave. But there are four major barriers that a lot of my clients will experience when they go to either buy a house or refinance and restructure. One of them is credit. And I would recommend that you go online to annualcreditreport.com. The government gives you a free credit report from each bureau every year, and you can go on there, print that out, look at it, make sure there are no errors on there. But another thing to keep in mind, to get your credit scores boosted as high as you can, if you will only use less than 30% of your credit limits on revolving accounts like your credit cards. So if you had a $1,000 credit limit, you would never use a penny over $300 at any time during the month. You're going to be pleasantly surprised at what happens to your credit score. Now, if you're really aggressive and you want to not use, if you want to use less than 10% of your credit limit and still have a balance, so they'll report each month, you'll really be pleasantly surprised. Stay away from 12-month savings cash. Those things, if you're going for a mortgage, the way they calculate the debt on that, even though you don't have to make a payment, it will kill your income to debt ratios. It will look like a maxed out revolving account, and it'll kill your scores too, your credit scores. So watch out for that. Make a deal with collection accounts. These people they've gotten really savvy, and now they report every single month on a collection that may have happened a year ago. It's like a sucker punch to the gut every time. If just make a deal with them, make a payment to them, whatever, make payments to them, whatever it takes to keep them from reporting on your credit. Here's another one, the appraisal. Sometimes the appraisal comes back and there's repairs that are needed. Here are some repairs that you need to go ahead and make a deal with the seller on who's going to pay for it, because more than likely your structural repairs are going to have to be done before you close. And those are things like broken heating and air systems, plumbing or electrical that doesn't work, rotted wood, a bad roof, drainage problems, John, yeah,
I
big.
Just talked to somebody with that problem.
Yeah, those. Yeah, if you're going in there to buy a house, you need to go ahead and figure out before you make the offer who's going to pay for those, who's going to do that before it closes. If you're a seller, you probably want to go ahead and have John come out on the drainage problem, have some things taken care of on those structural issues. Another one is income to debt ratios. If you're self-employed and you've been turned down and you've got good credit, you've been turned down because of income, give me a call. Let me take a look at all pages of your last 2 years' tax returns. I start at the back of the return and move forward. There are so many of those expenses that you legally wrote off that I can legally add back to your income. Just knowing under what circumstances we can do it, and I've helped multiple people who are self-employed to get over that barrier. So, you know, credit, income to debt ratios, appraisals, money down, y'all, you can get in for zero to very little down, even for investment property. People just don't know that you can do it. People think it's 20% down is a minimum. That's not true, even for investors.
You have so much experience at that, and it's really useful, and you're so helpful.
Well, thank you. I enjoy it. And, you know, many years ago, I had the opportunity to mentor personally under Robert Allen, who was the number one author for Nothing Down, Creating Wealth, The Challenge, out in San Diego. He was just a runaway bestseller author at the time. And when I got into the business many years ago, I decided, hey, if I'm going to do this, I might as well learn from somebody who's living my dream, who's doing it right, who's doing it the best at it. He was wonderful. I got to mentor with him out there. And now today, there are many people out there who can be mentors for you, just like the story of Martina, you know, just local friends here that were doing it, and she saw they were doing it right, and she learned from them. There's all kinds of help out there for you guys.
Yeah, but you need somebody you can trust like Joe.
Well, thank you, John. You're so sweet. Well,
hey,
look, we've enjoyed hanging out with you on Real Estate Mortgage Shop today. You can connect with me at jogarner.com. Real quick, John, how do we contact you?
call us at 901-754-7474.
All right, and we'll see you guys back next Saturday on Real Estate Mortgage Shop. Thank you for listening to Real Estate Mortgage Shop, where we offer you solutions to your real estate and financing scenarios. I'm Joe Garner, your host, mortgage professional. Catch this podcast and more at jogarner.com.